coming up on this edition of the FGCU Sports Report. FGCU's graduating student athletes are sent off in style. The Eagles baseball team struggles to stay in the hunt for postseason play. And we sit down with FGCU Director of Athletics Ken Kavanagh to get his perspective on this past sports season and what the future holds. All that and more on this week's FGCU Sports Report.
The FGCU Sports Report is made possible by Fort Myers Toyota, now part of Auto Nation with over 250 dealerships nationwide and offering a lifetime warranty on every new Toyota. And Mutual of Omaha Bank, matching the right financial service to the right customer at the right time. Mutual of Omaha Bank, your bank every step of the way. And the Eagles Club, FGCU Athletics Boosters Club, committed to providing the finest academic and athletic opportunities to FGCU student athletes. And Dr. John C. Kagan, treating joint pain, sports medicine, and general orthopedics for more than 30 years and proud to support FGCU athletics. And employee-owned Home Tech, serving Southwest Florida for 30 years with service agreements on air conditioning and all major appliances.
Hello, Eagles fans. I'm your host, Tom James, and welcome to this season's final edition of the FGCU Sports Report. Each year, FGCU must bid farewell to another graduating class of student athletes. To honor their achievements, both on and off the playing field, the university recently hosted a senior send-off and award ceremony to say goodbye and thank you to these graduates. Sports reporter Rod Clark was there and files this special report.
A four-year journey has come to an end for 52 student athletes at Florida Gulf Coast University. It was a journey of growth and discovery, a journey marked by soaring triumphs and bitter defeats, a time to build lasting friendships and delicately juggle the competing demands of the playing field versus the classroom. And for the university itself, it was a journey of exploration and change, with these graduating seniors pioneering the transition to big-time college athletics, but unable to fully enjoy the fruits of their own labors. FGCU recently said goodbye and thanks to these graduating pioneers at a combined senior send-off and award ceremony. It was a night for celebration of the end of that arduous four-year journey and of the extraordinary achievements of some of the travelers. Take Victoria Hidmark, for example. Her journey took her not just to a new school in a new town, but to another country and a different culture. Hidmark, a native of Sweden, was awarded the prestigious Eagle Scholar Athlete Award, the highest honor FGCU bestows upon a graduating senior student athlete. She said her experiences at FGCU will carry her into the future.
It was an amazing opportunity to get the offer to go here, and I made friends that I will have for the rest of my life and experience things that I would never have gotten to experience if I hadn't come over here.
In presenting the Eagle Scholar Athlete Award, FGCU President Wilson Bradshaw described Hidmark's amazing career. How amazing? Well, her long list of achievements includes leading the FGCU swimming and diving team to 3 straight Coastal Collegiate Swimming Association championships. And she holds school records in both the 100 and 200 meter backstroke. Still not impressed? Okay, she graduated with a Bachelor's of Science in Biotechnology with a double minor in Biology and Chemistry, and has already been accepted in the PhD program at the University of Florida. At FGCU, she compiled a GPA of 3.98.
Just how much it has made me grow to go to school here, to leave everything I knew, to just be here all by myself and figure stuff out all by myself, never been away from home.
The evening ceremonies also marked the announcement that what was formerly known as the Most Inspirational Award has been renamed in honor of the late Dwayne Swanson, the legendary supporter and benefactor of FGCU athletics. Shortly before his death in March, Swanson became the first person to ever receive an honorary letter from the FGCU athletic department. He was represented by his wife and son as baseball coach David Tillett made the announcement of the award name change. Dwayne Swanson inspired FGCU with his dedication and generosity. It was soccer goalie Adam Glick's grit and courage that earned him the Swanson Award. For three consecutive seasons, Glick and A-Sun Conference Defensive Player of the Year overcame, respectively, heat exhaustion, a surgically repaired broken bone, and a crippling staph infection. Last season, in only the fourth year of the program, he posted 8 shutouts, leading the Eagles to an undefeated regular season conference title. And here's some good news for fans and bad news for opponents. Since Glick sat out one of those seasons, he has another year of eligibility at FGCU.
It meant a lot just to go through a lot like that and then come back and have a great season like we did. And it was just very appreciative and very, very glad to get it.
The women's tennis team collected the Eagle Team Spirit Award, and soccer player Anna Jockety received the Community Service Award for the many long hours she has volunteered at a variety of local charities and programs, including the Children's Hospital and the Salvation Army. Individual Spirit Awards went to 4 FGCU student athletes: swimmer Taylor Cook, baseball player Stephen Wickens, basketball player Shannon Murphy, and soccer player AJ Johnny. The quartet of seniors was honored for their spirit and love of the game, as well as their dedication to their team and their teammates. What lessons have these outstanding young men and women learned at FGCU, on the playing fields and on the courts and in the classrooms, that will help propel them into a successful future?
For sure, time management. I mean, that's the main thing when you practice 20 hours a week and you have classes and you have homework and you have tests. You really have to be disciplined and you have to learn how to manage your time and to figure out yourself how you work the best.
Teamwork, probably the biggest thing. Going through adversity like I did. Just collaboration with people and just hard work.
Dedication, teamwork, time management, hard work in general. I've learned a lot just on the court, and then it transfers over into schoolwork and whatever else I pursue in life.
The biggest lesson I learned is being accountable. You got to show up, you got to give your best. You know, you're going to always be held accountable for your actions, and that was probably the biggest lesson I learned through these 4 years.
Earlier in this report, we described the class of 2011 as pioneers. For the past 4 years, they've competed at the NCAA Division I level against some of the best college teams in the nation. But these were transition years, meaning they were denied the chance to compete in Division I postseason tournaments. It was at times frustrating, especially for teams that won their conference championships, then had to go home, while lesser teams went on the hunt for glory.
And it's a little bittersweet too. You know, we never had the chance to go and do the postseason thing, but the reason most of us came and played for Bob is because we bought in. We wanted to be the first.
So as they leave the classrooms and the playing fields of college and take their places in the world, they can take pride in knowing that they laid the foundation for a long and proud sports tradition for the Eagles of FGCU.
Thanks, Rod. Now let's take a look at the FGCU sports action from this past week. The Eagles hosted conference leader and 14th ranked Stetson University for a crucial 3-game series this past weekend. In Friday's game, a pair of 2-out RBI singles in the top of the ninth helped Stetson break a 4-4 tie and take game one by a score of 6-4. Saturday's game was another heartbreaker for the Eagles as Stetson again rallied in the ninth, scoring 6 runs to turn a 3-run deficit into an 8-5 victory over the Blue and Green. And in Sunday's finale, Stetson didn't need any ninth inning heroics as they came out swinging and clobbered the Eagles 13-2. And before we close out the season, the Sports Report would like to give an Eagle shout out to some recent accomplishments. Eagles senior second baseman Michael Alvarez became just the second player in FGCU history and the fifth in A-Sun history to collect over 300 hits in his college career. Alvarez picked up his milestone hit on April the 29th against Jacksonville. Congratulations to Michael Alvarez on this impressive accomplishment. On Tuesday, May 10th, it was announced that FGCU softball standout Courtney Platt was named the A-Sun Conference Player of the Year for 2011. Platt was also the only unanimously selected player to be named to the postseason first team. The Naples native led the A-Sun in batting average, doubles, total bases, and walks this past season, and was seventh in the nation in on-base percentage. Eagle teammate Catherine McDaniel earned second team conference honors, while newcomers Kristen Bemnoski, Emily Lanier, and Tori Williams garnered spots on the all-freshman team. Congratulations to Courtney and her teammates on this prestigious accomplishment. And in the world of golf, it was recently announced that FGCU sophomore Brianna Carlson was a unanimous selection to the Atlantic Sun Women's Golf All-Conference First Team. Brianna is the first FGCU Women's Golf Team member to be chosen All-Conference. Congratulations to Brianna for this prestigious recognition of a fine season. And three members of the men's golf team earned some postseason accolades as well. Eagle Matt Cote was named the A-Sun Conference Freshman of the Year for his outstanding play throughout the year. Matt led all A-Sun freshmen by a full stroke with a 73.3 scoring average. And senior golfer Dan Mazziato was named to the A-Sun All-Conference First Team, while junior teammate Brandon Pena earned second team honors. Mazziato and Pena are the first two players in the FGCU golf program's history to earn all A-Sun Conference awards. Congratulations to Matt, Dan, and Brandon on these impressive awards for a great season. And as always, you can find all the latest news, scores, and highlights for all of FGCU sports at FGCUathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. For this week's first player profile, we shine the Sports Report spotlight on men's golf standout Nick Ahola. Take a look.
I chose FGCU basically. We're in Florida. I'm from Michigan originally. If you want to play golf, Florida's definitely one of the places you want to come to. Other than that, the campus is amazing. The coaching staff is great. I met a few guys on the team when I came down and got recruited, and they just made it seem like home, so it was really good from there on out. Best coaching advice, strictly mental. Our coaches, Mikey and Brent, have helped us out so much mentally, and not a lot of people realize how that's a huge aspect of golf. So mental coaching has been great. Being a senior next year is going to be great. It obviously comes with tremendous responsibility. You just have to be a leader always. If some of the younger guys are slacking off, you just kind of got to always be on them and give them as much guidance as you can. The best part, the team has been amazing. Coaching has been great too. All the guys were such a tight group of guys, really good friends. Everyone, anyone can mess with anybody on the team and be fine the next day. So it's kind of a brotherhood. It's been great. My plans after FGCU would, number one, to be a professional golfer. It's a tough task to handle, obviously, but I feel like I'm being prepared every year here, getting to play more and more golf on more and more courses, so I think it helps out a lot. And once I graduate, I'm going to go professional, so we'll see what happens.
Director of Athletics Ken Kavanagh, you were here for the first episode, now joining us for the last one. Good to have you.
Thank you.
Wrap it all up.
Great year. Thank you.
Yeah. As the 2010-2011 athletic campaign kind of winds down, tell me what achievements that you're most proud of for the entire department.
Well, it's certainly been a wonderful year. It started with basically finishing up the certification process that we're all excited to be moving forward to now everybody being eligible for the tournaments. Certainly the four championships were high water marks that we're always, when we get started, even though we couldn't go to the NCAA in a number of our sports, that was a goal for the teams, and the two soccers and swimming and women's basketball all winning those championships were very successful marks for us. And then, we still want to do the things off the playing courts and fields, and we looks like we have another grade point average of about 3.17 and about 3,500 community service hours from our student athletes. So when we start every year, those are the things we want to do. We want to do well in our chosen sports. We want to be in a position where the student athletes hopefully have a fun overall experience, and we want to be value added.
And the wait is over, as you mentioned. Finally, full-fledged Division I for FGCU. Man, you got to be so excited that that's finally here.
Well, and I only went through two of the 4 years, but a number of our staff have been here since day one, and Dr. Peg Gray-Vickery and Dr. Bradshaw did a great job leading us through the process with the NCAA, which was really a good opportunity for all of us to not only be viewed internally, certainly the NCAA peer review team came in, and to be able to showcase a great university setting for intercollegiate athletics.
FGCU now becomes more and more high profile. What challenges does that bring along with it?
Well, I think the biggest challenge in any position where you're not at the top of the food chain is to try to maintain your quality coaches. We have a significant number of our coaches, our head coaches in particular, who've been here since day one, and they've brought us so many good things. And, you know, we hope that we can try to find the resources to want them to envision retiring here. Certainly, that won't be probably the case for everybody, but that's our goal. If you lose someone, then, you know, you want to be able to have the situation in a good stead where somebody else wants that, and I think the scenario for us right now is to develop the resources not only for the coaches to go out and be able to have full scholarships in all our sports, which we currently don't have that right now, develop additional opportunities for some full-time assistant coaches, and to enhance some of our recruiting dollars. That's where we try to look at our Eagles Club and some other opportunities with our donors to shore those things up.
In March, you made the biggest move so far, arguably, of your tenure, change at the top of the men's basketball program. On March 3rd, Dave Balza removed his head coach, and March 31st, Andy Enfield hired as the new coach. You talk about March Madness. How taxing was that whole process?
Well, it was, first of all, it was very, I guess, rewarding to know that there was so much demand for our position. We had, I thought, a good position, but the number of folks that had the backgrounds, including Sweet 16 coaches and other coaches who had been in the NCAA tournament as head coaches really put us in a position, I think, of a favorable scenario. And Dr. Bradshaw was very helpful with me with his time and his ability to sell the university to our finalists. And in the end, we felt that we had the best fit and are very excited about Andy's hire.
And he hasn't even coached a game yet, Andy Enfield, and the Enfield effect is already being felt around with a bounce in interest, it seems like.
Yeah, I think a combination of the end of the season for women's basketball, the sellout against Florida with the WNIT, and the just tremendous energy that was in the arena, coupled with Andy's hire. Between Carl and Andy, they've been out in the community quite a bit, and they're being received very well, and that's resulting in right now much more increased ticket sales. The students that came to the games late in the year for women's basketball, not only for the game against Florida, but before that when we played Drexel in the first round, and prior to that when we packed the house for the game against East Tennessee State for the NCAA promotion that we wound up winning representing the Atlantic Sun. So I think the student enthusiasm is probably the big thing we're going to start off with next year, and Coach Enfield had talked about that in the recruiting process, and we look forward to seeing the high energy number of students coming out for all our sports, but in particular men's and women's basketball.
And the women's basketball team became almost rock stars in the Southwest Florida sports scene at one time there. How much fun was that to see that whole thing transpire and them become so popular as they did?
It was neat. It was well earned by Carl and the ladies in the program who just have an exciting brand. When you throw 55 three-pointers in a game and set an NCAA record and you make 20 and you almost break the record there, and you do that on a normal basis, it seems, and lead the country shooting threes, you have a fun product. The kids are enjoying themselves. The fans enjoy seeing that, and that's where it started building upon itself. And you know, some of the most enjoyable parts of that evening was to be in a position where you saw some of our really true first-time fans who were in a position where they knew they were there on the front end of this and got to see the entire place filled up. And I think that was heartwarming to see that, as well as Carl and other administrators who've been here a lot longer than I have that got to finally see that happen. So we hope to make that more of a common occurrence and in a situation where we can enjoy that and have the scoreboard finish the right way for us.
And also you mentioned with not only Andy Enfield, but the other coaches, a lot of new recruits already being brought in for the upcoming season.
Well, I think, again, what we're able to sell recently has been NCAA eligibility, postseason eligibility, which is what it's all about. And, you know, in all our sports, we believe that, you know, we've increased to the next level in terms of the ability to go after student-athletes against schools and the BCS conferences. And certainly last year, Chris Sale being National Player of the Year really helped our baseball program. But it also shone light in a lot of ways to other programs in terms of how FGCU student-athletes can be perceived. An All-American honored a couple years ago from Cheyenne Jenks in softball, and, you know, the national rankings this year for women swimming and diving and for men's soccer and so forth, really have continued to beat the drum that it's a great place to come play.
Shifting gears a little bit, the death of Joanne Swanson this spring, for whom FGCU's baseball stadium is named, obviously sad for everybody personally, but how lucky is FGCU to have felt the support from a man like that?
Oh, it's unbelievable. I was very blessed within the last couple of years to get acquired Dwayne's friendship in a position where just to witness his persona in regards to probably the best thing I always remember about Dwayne is his smile. And he would smile when he saw others enjoying themselves relative to what he could try to do to help them out. And again, just a class gentleman who helped not just FGCU athletics, but the entire university and the entire community in so many ways. And between Dr. Merwin and Dwayne Swanson, we've lost two great individuals who have helped build a legacy and a foundation for FGCU athletics. It's now responsible for us to live up to that.
And the growth has been so fast and so quick for the athletic department to this point. Do you have a crystal ball? Can you kind of look down the road and see where you'd like to have FGCU athletics as a whole in 5 years or 10 years?
Well, I think the first thing we want to always do is continue to have the quality young people that we have in our program now and be good ambassadors on a daily basis. There's some teams that win a lot more games in certain ways, but I don't think personify really what you want totally in intercollegiate athletics. But I'm very proud of our student athletes. We basically have about a 3.17 again, grade point average again this semester, with lends itself to that they're not just worrying about what they're doing for the professional ranks. And we have some individuals that have those capabilities. Hopefully they'll stay healthy and get those opportunities, but more than likely they're going to be in a position they're going to use their degree. And then what we want to do is continue to pursue the best. We don't want to limit ourselves. You look at VCU this year in terms of men's basketball, and you look at other programs, Fresno State in baseball and Louisiana Lafayette in softball, and so many other sports that don't have a BCS name to them that have made the highest pinnacle, whether it's the World Series or Final Four or be in a position to go to the Frozen Four, whatever it may be. You look at that's where we want to go to. Will we reach it in any or all of our sports? We don't know. But I think if we don't limit ourselves, we have a chance to get there. And I think there's so many great student athletes that are in the state of Florida that we keep at home, and others that would love to come down to our beautiful campus that we're having a great opportunity at recruiting.
Thanks for joining us, and it's been a pleasure to cover the entire department on the show this year.
Well, on behalf of our department, I just want to say thank you to the entire crew and the station. It's really been a tremendous recruiting opportunity, and our fans in the community really have loved it. And it's nice to go out and have people refer to the FGCU Sports Report, and you guys do a great job. Thanks so much.
Ken Kavanagh, thanks for joining us. And just a reminder, you can always friend the Sports Report on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter, and watch the Sports Report 24/7 on YouTube. Just log on to the addresses on the screen and enjoy. For our second player profile, we tee up some questions with FGCU men's golfer Giles Robin.
I chose FGCU simply because of the weather and mainly because of the program and how it was developing and how we're moving into Division One. So I felt it was a good opportunity to work and extend the program to better places. And my favorite memory was probably when this year we went to California. It's a pretty cool trip. We went to Monterey, played in a good tournament over there, and it's good fun. Just turned pro, so going to be playing on the West Coast Tour for a little while, and kind of trying to make some money playing golf now. We can turn pro straight after college, but I decided to turn pro just because I've got a year left here on my visa, and then I'm going to be working for a little bit, so you just kind of turn pro. Yeah, it feels good, but it's kind of sad at the same time. It's a great group of people, and we've been a good team. So yeah, it's sad, but at the same time, I'm excited about the future and golf in the future. The team atmosphere, definitely. It's competition between friends, and although we compete pretty hard on the golf course, we're a group of friends after golf, so I'm going to miss that.
Now let's take one last look at the FGCU sports schedule for the upcoming week. On Thursday, May 19th, the FGCU baseball team will wrap up conference play when it hosts Lipscomb for a three-game series at Swanson Stadium. This final homestand could be critical if the Eagles hope to make the conference tournament. If you haven't been out to an FGCU baseball game this season, here is your last chance to come on out and root the Eagles on. And as always, we wish the Eagles the best of luck. Well, the clock has run down and the buzzer has sounded, so turn out the lights because the party's over for this season's Sports Report. I just wanted to say we've had a great time coming to you each week to report on these amazing student athletes here at FGCU, and we hope that you've enjoyed it as well. We look forward to bringing you more in-depth behind-the-scenes coverage next year as the Eagles make their first run at full-on D1 competition. I'm Tom James. Thanks for watching all season, and go Eagles!